So, Nadav, did you go to this festival with your friends? I mean, who were you there with at the time?
Yeah, I went with one of my best friend Yoni. I knew only him over there, so I went with him, and we met a couple of his friends, like 20 of them.
Oh, just a couple, yeah.
Yeah.
Tell me, what was the festival like, and at what point did you realize something was wrong?
Okay, yeah, the festival was really organized. You know, it was great rave party. They were thinking about the smallest details, that you have a passage everywhere, and that no plastics inside. You know, you can only insert 6 packs of water bottles. And the atmosphere was great, good people. You know, everybody are just like, you can see in the eyes that good people are coming to enjoy and have fun and smiles. And so I arrived around 4:30, and at 6 o'clock I went to the main stage and started dancing, and you know, great, everything going great, sunrise coming. And 6:30 there we started seeing the interceptions of the Iron Dome, and that's when the security stopped the music and told us to get on the ground, and after a few minutes told us to leave the place and take our cars and leave. That's when I immediately just told my friend, Yoni, let's go. I mean, we have to get out of here. It's not everyone left. Many people stayed there, and we didn't think about what's going to happen. We just, you know, rockets from Gaza, it happens. But I felt like something is wrong. We're too close to the border, and we need to get out. So we packed our stuff, our tent, our everything, went to the car and started driving. There was a big traffic jam, and I think the moment when I really realized something is way off the normal is when I was in the traffic jam. There was a car coming behind us, car out of control, just passing everyone driving on the side of the road, until it reached like the center, central part. And I think it crashed, but I'm not sure. I just heard a noise. So I went out to see what's going on. And I saw a girl over there, on the floor, with her leg almost cut off, with blood, and someone is trying to treat her. And I didn't really understand that she got shot. I thought maybe it was a car accident, or I don't know, but then I heard shootings. So then it got really stressed. I went to the car, brought my water bottles, threw them away near that girl, and just ran with Yoni, my friend, away from the sound of the shootings, still not knowing what's happening. I still thought maybe, you know, it's just our soldiers are fighting terrorists or something like that. And so we ran off, but then in the direction we ran to, we heard more shooting noises. So we had only one direction to go to. It was east, away from the Gaza Strip. And we just started running and finding shelter. And at some point, bullets were flying towards us. So I didn't see the terrorists. I just heard the bullets whistling. So we got on the ground, trying to stay as low as we can. On the break we had, we just ran for our lives to the next place that they can't see us, like near trees, near anything. But still, we heard some shooting. Even one time, it was like I had it like it's in a 100 meter radius. I had it much stronger than before. So again, running for our lives, just keep going. And so I think when the shooting started, that's when things got really, really like stressed and bad. And you can see people over there, you know, it's a rave party. So people aren't sober, you know, so you can see them confused and in a bad shape. I wish I could help people. The only thing went through my mind is I have to get out of here with Yoni. Like, that's the only thing that matters right now. Like, me and him going out of there safe. I had two things going on my mind. Like, one of them was I was speaking with the guy, like, wow, like, what kind of lesson are you trying to teach me here? Like, or should I now understand that I might die, like, be whole with it, you know? The other thing was just immediate, like, okay, I hear shootings, where do I go now? What do I do next? Okay, I'm here, I still don't feel safe. What now? Like, every couple of minutes.
Reassessing,
looking around. Okay, where to go next? Okay, we have a minute and 30.
A minute 30?
Minute 30.
Do you have somewhere safe here?
Yeah.
Or okay.
Okay, so it's downstairs. Just come calmly. We have like quick and calm, and it's all okay. Are you okay?
I'm okay. Are you okay?
Yeah.
I'm sure. I'm sure you hear the sirens like this a lot in Israel, but it feels different now, right?
Yeah.
Hey, are you okay? Did you get the driver to come in? He's in here. Okay.
יש פה צוות צילום אוסטרליה שבא לעשות רעיון. זה בסדר?
צוות חדשות מערוץ 7
I'm sure you're used to hearing the Iron Dome, hearing mm-hmm. the sirens here, but does it feel different now after what's happened? Do you think people are a bit more on edge at the moment?
The people, I think there's more a stressful environment about it. I'm not sure that.
Are you guys okay?
Yeah, we're okay.
Oh gosh, you're used to this now, aren't you?
Yeah. Not yet, but.
אתם בסדר, אני חושב שהם מצלמים.
כן, כן, זה בסדר.
So this is life in Israel at the moment, right?
Yeah. But you know, we are very strong.
Yes.
We know how to fight and we win.
Yeah. I mean, you're a country. You're a country at war now.
Yeah.
What does it mean to you?
It's not in the first time, you know, our children are also in the army.
So, girls, ever since you were little babies,
you've been coming for eight years. And they know, we used to come, they were very, very small. I took them on my hands and they didn't understand. We went down, and now, last time it was 2 years ago.
Yeah.
It was very traumatic. It was in the middle of the night. They still sometimes hear sirens. The impact of that is very long.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Girls, what do you understand? What do you know about what's happening in Israel at the moment?
I don't know how to explain this in English.
I know it's hard, isn't it? It's okay. Maybe you can tell me in English. What you've seen the news? I'm sure you've seen some of the bad things that have happened. So. I know it makes people a bit nervous when there's cameras, but what do you think the feeling is in here when you see the news and you see some of the things that have happened?
I'm not feeling that good because this is really, really sad.
That was it.
Okay. That's the Iron Dome.
Probably there was no alarm because it went to open field.
I put my phone down somewhere.
Hopefully we won't see you again.
Is your phone here?
My phone? Yeah, I brought it down here, but what did I do? Okay, I'm just going to go back a little bit to where we were in the story. You managed to escape eventually. Was that because the gunfire stopped? How did you know it was safe to how did you get out in the end?
We had two security guards escorting us. So I was talking with one of them. He told us just keep going. We're soon over there. I saw a big tent, but it wasn't the safe spot. It just after that spot, I stopped hearing gunshots. I stopped hearing a falling of the rockets, only the interceptions. And at that point, it felt like we're far away from there, and we can just walk. We walked a few more hours.
Wow.
We had no water or food or shade or anything.
You walked out of there eventually.
We walked down.
You are thankfully okay. You're sitting here now.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, your friend Yoni, is he okay? And what about the 20 other people? Did you?
Yeah, Yoni is fine. He's also processing the experience. The other people near us, I didn't get to talk to them too much. Eventually we arrived to a village, hundreds of us. You can see in the faces, some are terrified, some are shocked, some looks more calm, some are smiling, it varies.
Yeah. Do you know if... did you the group you were with, do you know if any of them passed away, if any of them were injured, or was everyone okay?
So the group I walked with, we went early enough to be out of sight. I heard stories of people I saw there. I have some, Yoni took a video when we left, and we recognized there a couple that got kidnapped.
Is that Noah, the one on the motorbike?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A couple, one on, I think it was even a donkey or something, I don't know, but one girl and a boy, we recognized them in our video, that if we stay there sitting, we could be them. But I personally, I don't know people.
Well, when you heard the death toll, 260 something.
I was shocked. I was definitely shocked. I don't think I grasped how big this event was. I mean, when I arrived back, we had someone drove us back to Tel Aviv. When I arrived, I was me and Yoni, we were joking around, laughing, and then I saw my girlfriend. She was terrified. The next day, she told me how many people were killed there. I was shocked.
Now that you've seen the videos, you have an understanding of what has happened, not just at the festival, but around. What is the emotion now for you?
Now it's been a few days, so I had some time to process. I am still processing, but I'm really sad about it. All the people that are now, that are kidnapped, they don't know what's going to happen with them, and the people that are killed and their family, it's awful. I'm in very much pain for them.
You're in pain for them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's terrible. Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.